Now taken, that's it, Australia all out.
Australia's very manhood suffered a crushing blow last Thursday with one of the shortest innings in Ashes history. That caused Australian media to effectively declare the end of the world.
I have suggested they be stripped of their citizenship.
Yes, that has crossed my mind.
The main fall guy so far, Captain Michael Clarke, who's now announced he's leaving the game.
It's the right time. I'm happy with my decision.
The team's coach, Darren Lehman, also shouldered some of the blame.
As a coach and a selector, we've got things wrong.
A close contender in the blame game has emerged in the form of WAGs, the wives and girlfriends. Yes, those meddlesome women have been distracting men from the important work of sports yet again, at least according to cricket commentator Ian Healy.
Your mind needs to be completely focused on it. Cricket is a sport that requires complete concentration.
Yes, sport requires the highest levels of concentration from players and onlookers alike. And Mr. Healy is not the only one blaming the ladies. An exclusive in this morning's Courier Mail delivered some sick burns to Michael Clarke, but also blames a feud between two of the wives as a main contributor to the Ashes, or crashes. To help us call out some serious bullshit on this issue, we thought we would go to the experts. Well, the soccer experts, at least. We are SBS, after all.
Hey, Luz. Yeah. Have a sec?
Great.
How warranted is the claim that the big bad WAGs are to blame?
I think it's completely unwarranted. We as a nation need to accept that we were outplayed that day, for the entire test, in fact, and that it had nothing to do with the WAGs at all.
As it turns out, blaming the women is a time-honoured tradition in cricket, stretching all the way back to pre-World War II era. In the 1930s, Australian players' wives were forbidden from being in the same country when on tour. And again in 1989. In the 2005 Ashes tour, the WAGs once again copped criticism for the poor performance on the pitch. And who can forget in 2010, Michael Clarke's then-fiancée Lara Bingle was dubbed the Yoko Ono of Australian cricket after he flew home over that nude photo scandal. But if the women are really to blame, we wondered, are men ever the cause of distraction in the ladies' sports?
No, because as women, we can handle ourselves, right?
Do you think we should just de-sex all of our sports players and be done with it?
Yes.
One person who would disagree is the man at the centre of the scandal himself, Paul Clarkey.
You know, wives and girlfriends being on tour is a distraction for us. What a load of shit. You know, that's absolute garbage.
Yes, the man who has taken the fall for all this is one of the only ones standing up to the sexist blame game. Good on you, Clarkie.